Today we are installing an AirDog II 4G on a 2009 Ford F-250. This is AirDog part number A6SABF494. This is for the 08 to 2010 Ford 6.4 liter trucks. The AirDog II 4G is AirDog's newest offering in their pump lineup. This is a really, really nice pump, and some of the newest features that this pump has is this is a four bearing design pump, which is going to reduce amp draw, and that's going to make it a really super, super quiet pump on the truck, which is really, really nice. They have incorporated a intermediate shaft between the pump and the gear rotor now. This adds an extra seal. So this is going to keep you from having the wet motor issue of diesel fuel leaking into the motor and taking the motor out. So they've gone an extra step and done that for you. This is going to pretty much eliminate motor failures because of wet motor. So really super quiet pump, reduced amp draw, four bearing design, really, really neat pump. Another new feature that they've got going into this pump series is they've got a 90-degree elbow here for your fuel pressure. This is gonna bring it out at 90 degrees, and this will be a 1/8 by 27 MP plug right here, so you can put your fuel pressure gauge sending unit right there, which is a whole lot easier to get to than it was on the other pumps. Of course, they've also moved the motor out, so the motor is almost the entire width of the motor base. So. New pump. We've done several AirDog videos in the past, so I'm not going to go through every step of this. I'm going to try to blow through it, but the 6.4 is going to be a new install video for us, so we're going to try to get down to the nitty-gritty of what makes the install different as opposed to anything else. So going to fly through the mounting here real quick. So we just take our mounting bracket, your two holes at the top. You want those at the top because you'll have the two at the top and then the single hole at the bottom. So inside of your hardware kit, you'll get your extension block. You're going to go ahead and get the bracket out that the AirDog is going to be mounted to itself, and then your hardware bag with all your hardware in it. Your four long Allen bolts, just go ahead and get them, and then there will be the beveled side of the plate. Go ahead and throw four of them in there, and just flip your plate over, slide your spacer block on top of it. Then make sure you remember that your orientation of the two holes to the top. Go ahead and put your AirDog bracket on. Now you'll want to make sure that this is going to fit and clear everything on your truck wherever you're deciding to put it. But for our truck, it's going to clear. So we're going to add our four lock washers here. And then the corresponding nuts to go with it and tighten it down. Now that you've got the pump bracket assembled to the frame bracket for your AirDog, you're going to want to assemble the AirDog to the bracket. So first step is you're going to remove both of the filters from the AirDog, the pump base. And then in your hardware pack, there will be four Allen-headed cap screws about the smaller size of the two that are in there that are Allen-headed. The pump rest on top of the bracket. We get a lot of calls about this as well. Then the Allen bolts actually just drop right through. When they drop through, they're flush with the base of the motor, so they're not sticking up, so it makes for a real nice install. So we're going to install all four of those, nut and a lock washer on those, and that will have our pump motor assembled to the base. All right, we've now got our AirDog pump motor assembled to our bracket. What we're gonna do now is the most important part of this video, and the guys at AirDog will be mad at me if I did not tell you this and point this out to you. We're going to assemble our fittings to the base. These are MPT fittings, so they do not have to be driven into the base all the way up to the hilt. They've only got to go until they're tight. Before you put these into the pump base, you're gonna wanna coat these with motor oil as well. Do not over tighten these. If you over tighten these, it's going to roll the threads and crush them inside the pump base, and then you're in trouble. So first thing we're going to do is we're going to take our plugs out of the pump base, our plastic plugs that AirDog provides to protect your fittings. Now when you're inserting your fittings, again, you don't want to over tighten these and roll the threads seven or 3/4 and 5/8. These are the 3/4 fittings. They're both the same for the larger. So I'm just going to tighten these down snug. Okay, that's good right there. Then the return fitting, which is 5/8. We'll go ahead and tighten it down. And the tank side, which is going to be on the back side here. Make sure you do not cross fit when threading it into the base. Should go 2 or 3 turns before it starts getting tight. Snug that down. Then that's got our fittings installed. So after your fittings are installed, all you need to do then is go ahead and put your, if you want to, go ahead and put your filters back on your base. Don't have to, but it'll keep you from possibly bending your straw. We'll assemble the filters back to the base, and now we're ready to put the pump in the truck. Okay, now we're going to begin assembling our AirDog pump to the truck's frame. Now you just want to pick a spot on the truck's frame rail that is suitable for you. You know, it's going to be different strokes for different folks here, but you want to just take your back side of your frame, the back side of the frame, your backing plate will be the one without the recessed holes in it. I like to put the 2 bolts on the top, so I'm going to go ahead and put my back plate up now where I want my pump to go. Then I'm going to bring my pump up and just sit it on the top bolts. Hook it on the top bolts. Like so. All right, so we'll go ahead and get our bolts on that. That's the position that I want the pump to be in. We're gonna put our single bolt on the bottom here. I'll probably take it the other way. We're gonna go ahead and tighten our bracket down from there. Okay, now here's a shot of our AirDog mounted on the frame rail on our 6/4. What we're gonna begin doing now is routing lines. Consult your manual as to which hose is which, but our pressure hose is the first one we're gonna mount. So we're gonna go ahead and route this across the frame rail and up towards the front of the truck to the fuel conditioning module, which is on the inside of the frame rail, located right behind the front drive shaft. Get a good shot of there, right there. So we're gonna route our engine pressure line and our return line from the AirDog both up into this general area to begin our connections. On our fuel conditioning module, the first thing that we're gonna have to do is we're going to disconnect. The first line that we're gonna work with from our AirDog is going to be the engine supply line. So on this module, the smaller lines at the top, those are the engine return lines. The larger lines at the bottom, those are the engine pressure line or supply pump pressure from the tank to the engine. So what we're going to do is we're going to disconnect this line right here. And to disconnect it, there's 2 blue tabs on it. We just squeeze those together and pop the line off. I'll have to put the camera down to do this, and I can't get a good shot of it, but I wanted to make sure that I showed this. So I'm going to disconnect that, and I'm going to connect my AirDog line to that and give you a shot of what that is to look like. Here's a shot of our AirDog engine supply line hooked to the factory fuel line right here. So what we've done is we've routed this over the frame rail, and it will be going out to the AirDog to this larger of the 2 connections right here. We're going to go ahead and hook that up now. Now you can see with the supply line connected, you have a lot of extra hose. That's what this little packet that's AirDog supplies you with of male splices are for. These are 1/2-inch male splices pushed to lock. What we're gonna do is we're gonna take our supply line, we're gonna get it routed the way we want to, we're gonna mark it and cut it, and then we're gonna install one of these splices. We're gonna shorten and clean up our lines, and we'll show you that once we've got it done. Okay, now we wanna give you a shot of what it looks like when the lines are cut and cleaned up. So we cut the lines there, put the male splices in just like we showed you inside the kit. Now we have moved on and taken care of the return line. So this little metal T here, this metal T is supplied by AirDog, and these are the two factory return lines that are normally attached to the fuel module at the very top lines, the smaller two lines. So we disconnected both of those, and then we connected our AirDog return line to the bottom of this T. The AirDog return line, we then ran over the frame rail, and we are going to hook it back to the AirDog again on the smaller two T's. We're gonna cut the line, and then we're gonna clean it up as well, and then we're gonna move on to our suction line to the tank. Okay, so now we have our AirDog return line and our pressure line going to the engine hooked up on the AirDog. Now we're going to move to our suction line, which is on the back side of the AirDog. You can see right there beside of your pressure regulator. So the suction line on this Ford truck has to be directly attached to the tank. So what we did was we went ahead and dropped out the drive shaft at the back just so we could have a little room to work. And then on top of the tank, right here through this cutaway, you will find the top of the sending unit. On top of the sending unit, we are going to disconnect the suction line. I'm gonna get up there and I'm gonna show you which one is the suction line. Okay, now we're on top of the tank. There's two lines on the tank. This line right here is the smaller of the two. This is the engine return line. The one closer to the outside of the frame, right here where my pick is, this is the engine suction side. We're going to disconnect this line, just like we have the other lines, and we are going to attach the AirDog suction line here. Here it is, right here, larger of the two. Now we've got our AirDog plumbed in on our 6.4 truck. Now we're down to the home stretch. We're gonna be putting our wiring harness on. So I wanna talk a little bit about the wiring harness. The wiring harness in this kit, and most all of the other AirDog kits as well, are pretty much the same. There's gonna be a few differences from truck to truck, but the 6.4 one, this is pretty much a universal one that's gonna be used on all of them. So just kind of go over how the harness is. This is the relay, and I've got this folded up. This is the leads that would go down to if you had the low pressure fuel light on this AirDog. It's an orange and a blue set of leads at the time of this filming. Your main fuse here, you always, if you ever have an electrical problem, you want to check here first. Now the harness itself, there's three leads coming off of it. There would have been four leads, but I folded up the low pressure fuel light. So our lead that goes to the harness, that has got the plug for the AirDog pump, and then it's got the plug for what would have been the low pressure fuel light again. Then you've got the trigger harness, the trigger power harness. Now normally this would go to a key on fuel source, but we're gonna actually gonna wire this in to the wiring harness for the stock fuel pump. And then that way it'll work exactly in the same way that of course the stock fuel pump did. And then you've got your ring terminals on here for your constant power source. So constant power, key on power that turns the pump on, and then the drop that goes to the AirDog pump, and then your relay, and of course, the drop harness that we won't be using for the low pressure fuel light. So that's a quick overview of the harness. We're gonna go ahead and start out in our underhood portion of this. We're gonna get that in there and then get our drops down the frame rail, and we'll show you where we hook up from there. All right, we have begun our wiring and we're down at the AirDog now. So we brought the longest part of your harness that goes back to your AirDog. We've brought it back and hooked it in at the AirDog. You can see up there at this connection here, that is the power source for the AirDog. The unconnected side here would have been for, again, if we had the low pressure light for the AirDog. Now we're gonna show you where we're gonna hook up our key on power source. So we're gonna be back at the fuel module. And what I'm gonna show you now is where we're gonna be hooking up your trigger wire. So your trigger wire on the AirDog is the wire that would have normally had the mini tap in it, just a single red power wire. On the Ford fuel control module, there are two electrical connections right here. This is the connection for the water and fuel sensor. Above that, going into the actual pump motor itself, is the connection for the pump. So we're going to disconnect that. You can see there's two wires in the loom there. There's a purple wire and a black wire. You'll want to test this with the test light, but your purple wire is going to be your power source. We're going to cut the power source, and going back towards the ECM side, we're going to hook up our AirDog trigger wire directly to that. So when the computer sends power to what was the stock lift pump, it's going to be sending power to the AirDog. So we're going to cut that and splice and solder that in now. And then our final connection on our AirDog electrical harness is going to be the constant power source. Now, we wired this up at the battery. If you want a corrosion-free connection, then you'd wire it up at the alternator, positive to the positive lead on the alternator, then a ground to a body ground. But this has got our wiring done. So our bleeding procedure now for the truck is go ahead and turn the key on. Make sure that once you turn the key on, that the AirDog is running. Once you have verified that the AirDog is running, then just give it a few key cycles there. And there's our AirDog right there. You can see it doesn't hang too low on the frame rail. You want to give it a couple of key cycles so we know that the pump fills up. After a few key cycles, then go ahead and try to start the truck and let the truck start and idle for a little bit of time there. So that's the AirDog install. 2009 Ford 6.4 liter. If you have a question on this installation or any of our other installations, please give us a call. Thank you.